So how do I know if I have an addiction? Well, this is Jason from Soulfire. Here in this video, I want to talk about some indicators that would show that you have an addiction in your life. Here on this channel, we want to offer gospel hope for a porn-filled world. Let's get right into this. Let's talk about how you know if you have an addiction. Well, a lot of times people will argue or maybe try to say that they don't have an addiction in your life. It can certainly feel better to tell yourself you don't have addictive behavior, that you can quit anytime you want. In fact, I've heard lots of people even argue that they don't believe that pornography in itself is an addiction. One of the things we're doing here in November is a lot of people try this No Porn November thought. And one of the reasons that groups would do that is they're trying to prove to people, okay, if you don't think porn is an addiction in your life, try to go 30 days without it. See if you can easily do that. If that's a challenge, there's a pretty good indicator that you have an addiction in your life. But one of my favorite quotes on addiction comes from Dr. Doug Weiss. And Doug says this about addiction: when you cannot stop your behavior, when you're spending more time and money than you thought you would, when you've been caught or had consequences but continue anyway, when you've made promises to quit and can't fulfill those promises to yourself, God, your family, and your wife, you most likely have an addiction. So one of the things that he would point us to is, listen, you simply cannot stop your behavior. That's a pretty good sign that you have an addiction. And it tends to escalate. You end up spending more money than you thought you would, more time. One of the ways that I see addictive behavior occurring is when we are supposed to be doing something, say school, time with our family, time with friends, and all of a sudden this addiction begins to crowd those things out. Formerly, behavior that we thought was life-giving, time with friends or hobbies or whatever it might be, even things you're supposed to be doing like schoolwork or work, and all of a sudden your addiction begins to get in the way. Your addiction begins to crowd out the things that you know you're supposed to be devoting time to. These are some pretty good indicators that the behavior is not just something you're struggling with, but it has actually grown to a full-blown addiction. Maybe you've even tried some radical changes. You've done groups, you've tried to white knuckle through behavior, you've gotten rid of technology, you've done all those things, and yet the behavior and the struggle and the temptation continues. That's a pretty good sign that you have an addiction. Well, I had a friend years ago who really had a hard time saying that he was an addict. He really wanted to eliminate that word from his mind. He was trying to convince himself that it wasn't true. What would be the root of that? Well, quite simply, it's pride. We would prefer to not say that we are an addict. An addict is forced to, like somebody who hits the bottom, admit that they need serious help. But the beauty of admitting that you are an addict, one of the reasons it's so important to admit that is whether you say you're an addict or not will indicate how hard you are willing to fight to get to freedom. You see, if you convince yourself, I'm not an addict, then you won't take radical steps. You won't do whatever is necessary to get to freedom. But if you're willing to admit, you look at the reality of your situation, you say, you know what? I am an addict. I need serious help. Then you're gonna be willing to come to the table with everything that is necessary. Hopefully get some help, hopefully get some treatment, bring some people into your life, submit to a process that you could get to freedom. One of the challenges on addictions is that it really could take years. You see, if you've had an addiction to pornography in your life for a few years, maybe even decades, as I share my story, I had about a 10-year period where I was addicted to pornography. It's gonna take years to get to freedom. In my life, it was somewhere between 2 and 5 years before I felt really extreme freedom from these temptations. And that's one of the realities of addictions. But one of the other beauties of addiction is that the gospel of Jesus Christ is for the addict. Now, I did an entire video on this. I'll link that right here. I believe that the beauty of admitting that you were an addict is that, hey, the gospel is for people like you. The gospel is for people like me. Jesus said he came not to call the righteous, but sinners. You see, the gospel is for addicts. So as you think about your situation, if you are struggling to admit, I am an addict, don't do so for reasons of pride. Understand that what Jesus came to offer was for people like you. And be willing to say, where am I right now? Am I an addict? I want to get some help. I want to move toward freedom. Well, love to hear what you think. What are some ways that you would know that indicate that you are an addict? Be sure to place those comments below. Subscribe if this was helpful and you want to see more content like this. This is Jason for Soulfire. I will catch you in the next one.